हाय स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर एम अशरफ मजरू, प्रोफेसर ऑफ कम्युनिटी मेडिसिन। आई वेलकम यू इन द लर्निंग सेशन ऑफ केस सीरीज एपिडेमियोलॉजिकल स्टडीज। दिस इज द थर्ड सेशन ऑन एपिडेमियोलॉजी। लेट्स सी द एजेंडा पॉइंट्स ऑफ दिस सेशन। द एजेंडा ऑफ दिस सेशन इंक्लूड्स रीकैप ऑफ स्टडी डिजाइंस, केस सीरीज डेफिनेशन एंड कॉन्सेप्ट, population and clinical case series, methodology steps, comparative methodology guidelines, strength and limitations, frequently asked questions, manuscript for publication. So let's take agenda points one by one. So first is the recap of epidemiological study designs. If we look at the study designs, they are generally categorized as descriptive studies, observational analytic, and experimental analytic. In descriptive studies, we describe the disease by time, place, and person, or disease distribution. And in observational analytic studies, we make comparison between groups, disease versus non-disease, exposed versus non-exposed. And in experimental analytic studies, the exposure is induced by the investigator himself. So if we go into the detail of descriptive studies, it include case report, case series, ecological correlational studies, descriptive cross-sectional studies. Again, analytic cross-sectional studies, because cross-sectional study can be designed as descriptive as well as analytic. Then case control studies, cohort studies, and validation studies. In validation studies, the screening tests are validated against the gold standard diagnostic tests. Then are the experimental study designs. These are the clinical trials, preventive trials, and randomized and non-randomized control trials. So if we look at the overall classification of epidemiology, analytic versus descriptive, this is the descriptive category, and these are the studies which are falling in analytic category, where we compare different groups. And if we classify on the basis of observational and experimental studies, these two categories, descriptive and observational analytic, they fall under the observational studies, and the experimental include the clinical preventive trials. They are falling under the category of interventional or experimental studies. So this is which is overlapping this category. That is why it is known as observational analytic study. Up till now, we have discussed the detail of case reports, and now we will move on to the case series study. So let us see the case series study, what is the definition and the concept of case series study. Reporting data from group of coherent and consecutive set of cases of disease, syndrome, or health problem is defined as the case series study. A group of patients with similar diagnosis are undergoing the same procedure followed over the time in case series. The case series may be used in several settings, and usually they are classified as population case series and clinical case series. So let's see the detail of population and clinical case series. So first we will deal with the population case series studies. When cases are reported from defined population through healthcare outlets and other surveillance points, then it falls under the category of population case series. In population case series, information is desired about the criteria of the cases to be included in the study, and the population boundaries and characteristics from which the cases are reported. So for population case series, defined cases and the defined population both are desired. The population boundaries and characteristic need for the description of the distribution of the disease by person, place and times. And if we look at the importance and value of population case series, they are useful for epidemic investigation, disease surveillance and efficacy of program and program monitoring, resources allocations, disease early warning, research hypothesis for analytic study. So these are main utilities of the population case series. Now let us see the clinical case series. When cases are reported by one or more clinicians from healthcare setting, where population may or may not be defined, it may be from a single physician or hospital reports of outcomes, or it may be from multiple institutional registry by health institution or organization. So this is the definition and concept of clinical case series. The clinical case series are very useful for studying the sequence of symptoms and signs, outcome of treatment and surgical interventions, effectiveness of nursing care in the hospitals, clinical audit of the case management, and developing etiological hypothesis. So this is the importance of clinical case series. Now let's see what are the examples of study titles in case series. The sequence of symptoms, the example of the title is the sequence of symptoms and signs of neuropathy in diabetic patient. This title is important for clinical case series for diagnostic criteria and studying the sequence of sign and symptoms. Then the title is Diagnostic Outcome of Acute Flaccid Paralysis Cases Reported from Pakistan. This is population case series for disease surveillance. And if we look at another title, Study of Waiting and Follow-up Time for Elective Surgery in Public Hospitals of Punjab. This is an example where clinical case series is used for healthcare facility assessment. And another title, Mapping and Clinical Ranking of COVID-19 Cases Reported from Lahore Division. This is population case series for disease distribution and developing the hypothesis. Clinical audit of cardiac catheterization against the standard protocol checklist. This title is very unique. This is for clinical case series of healthcare standards, assessment of healthcare standards. So there is a diversity of titles and the areas of study in the case series studies. So the case series studies are very important. Let's learn the methodological steps in conduction of case series. So if we look at the steps of case series conduction, it includes framing of study questions and drafting objectives, defining the cases and setting the inclusion criteria, systematic data collection and data analysis, drawing inferences. So if we look at the objectives, the objective must be clearly defined, clearly framed study question must be there, and objective may be reframed with the data outcome. Sometimes the data outcome may not be those which are expected initially, and then we can reframe the study objectives and reconsider the study questions. Now in the case definition, the operational definition of cases is required. Inclusion criteria must be based on the case definition, and the description of reference population is required in population-based case series. Then the systematic data collection needs objectively developed tool and pre-tested. And then pile of sufficient cases to minimize the error in the findings. The data analysis must be systematic data analysis through certain software, and result must be compiled systematically. The discussion must be done through the review of literature in the light of literature and with inductive and deductive reasoning. And conclusion must be based on the data-driven facts. So these are the key steps in conduction of case series. Let's have the comparison of methodology guidelines. If we look at the study parameters regarding classification, study question, study population, case definitions, sample size, sampling technique, preferred sources of data, analytic approach, strength of evidence, and utility. If we compare the classification, both are descriptive study designs in clinical case series and in population case series. If we talk about the study questions, it is optional for population case series, but it is objectively framed in clinical case series. If we look at the study population, the reference population must be unknown in case of population case series, and the case definition for inclusion criteria must also be known. So in clinical case series, the focus is on the cases. Cases must be representative of sick population. And then case definition for both population, defined population, and definition of the cases. And in clinical case series, the inclusion criteria of cases is required based on the operational definition of the cases. The sample size is optional in population case series. Whatever the outcome reported from the population is included in analysis. But in clinical case series, the estimation of sample size is desired to minimize the sampling error. Sampling technique is purposive sampling in both the clinical and population case series. Preferred data sources, primary data sources is preferred, and preferred primary, but secondary data can be used in clinical case series. Analytic approach, descriptive and in both the cases, and strength of evidence can be generalized over the population, as the denominator is known, and the generalization should be with caution. And the utility, main utility of population case series is epidemic and surveillance of endemic diseases, monitoring of the diseases, disease early warning. And the clinical case series describe the outcome of clinical diagnosis and case management. So this is the comparative guidelines for both population case series and clinical case series. So let's see the strength and limitation of the series. If we look at the strengths, they have high external validity, no interference in treatment decision process, and inexpensive and short duration. Population-based are useful for epidemic and endemic monitoring, provide strong basis for generation of etiological hypothesis. If we look at the limitations, they lack in comparison group and can't be substituted with the randomized controlled trials. The efficacy of the drug procedure can't be studied through this design. Subject biases may occur. Result can't be generalized. And high level of conflict of interest may exist if the studies are funded or sponsored. So these are the limitations of the case series studies. Now, frequently asked question, there are very interesting questions which are frequently asked. Can we investigate efficacy of drug surgical procedure by using the case series designs? The answer is no. It can only provide description details of the outcome, prognosis of the treatment, and for efficacy, we need a randomized controlled trial. The other question, can we consider case series as a non-randomized controlled trial? The answer is no. In case series, controls are not used and it is just described the natural event in the clinical settings and the procedure which are naturally used in the case management. Is it possible to estimate incidence estimation in clinical case series? The answer is no. In clinical case series, the outcome and prognosis and survival time are analyzed. But in case of population-based case series, where denominator population denominator is known, then the incidence can be estimated. Can we take cases of the case series as the cases of case control study? The answer is yes. If we take matching controls for cases in case series, the design can be improved as case control analytic studies. So these are the frequently asked questions. Now the manuscript for publication, the components of the manuscript include the title, abstract, introduction, objectives, methodology, results, discussion, conclusion, references, and annexures are optional. And if we look at the title, it should reflect the key objectives and study location. The abstract should have the summary depicting the objectives, methodology, abstract of results, and conclusion. Introduction must be a brief context of the problem under study and rationale in the light of current literature view and the reference citation. The objectives clearly framed a study question and objectives. Methodology must include the study design, setting, duration, inclusion criteria, data collection procedure, analysis plan, ethical issues, etc. The result findings synthesized and systematically narrated with diagnostic, clinical and epidemiological outcomes. The discussion should the study findings in the context of findings in the other studies with inductive and deductive reasoning. Conclusion must be based on data drawn facts. The references with citation style as desired by the journal and annexure are used when diagnostic therapeutic protocols are there, scales, criterions used in the case management. So this is about the publication manuscript. As we are consecutively taking the session of epidemiological study designs, next we will take the correlational or ecological studies. Thank you very much for sparing your time.